Papu lives in a relation. Let us see the definition. Let A and B, just you split here, then it will be easy to memorize, easy to understand. Let A and B be any two non-empty set. Let A and B be any two non-empty sets. It is same for Cartesian product also, isn't it? You have studied the definition for Cartesian product. The same sentence, it repeats here. Next, a relation R from set A to set B. Because this A represents one relation. A relation R from set A to set B. So that only I am saying here set A, set B. Because this A is different from this A. A relation R from set A to set B is a subset of A cross B. So in your lifetime you won't forget, I think. Relation is a subset of the Cartesian product. Whenever they are asking what is meant by relation, it is a subset of the Cartesian product. Why I am saying instead of A cross B? Because the set name, it may differ. So in general, while they are asking how, you have to say it in answer. Relation is a subset of the Cartesian product. Under some specified conditions, why we are saying it is a subset? The answer is given here. Satisfying some specified conditions. If X is an element of A, that is set A. X is an element of A, is related to Y is an element of B, that is set B. Through R, this R is nothing but relation. This R is nothing but relation. Through R, you are relating an element from A to an element from B. Do you follow? Through the relation R, an element from set A is related to an element in set B. Then we write it as which one? X or Y. X is related to Y. X or Y, if and only if X comma Y is an element of relation. Do you follow? So this is the definition for relation. So this is the first point. Second point, it is the subset of the Cartesian product satisfying some specified condition. That's all. Do you follow? Then how can we write this X or Y? X is an element of A, Y is an element of B. That's all. Then if and only if X comma Y is an element of R. Then let us see what is meant by domain. Domain of the relation is, just you see, simply you should not say set A is the domain. No. Just see the illustration file. Every element in domain, every element in first set, it cannot be a domain. Every element in first set, it cannot be a domain. When it satisfies the condition to form a relation, then it is a domain. Here you see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 elements are there. But what is domain? 1, 2, 3, 4. Only these 4 elements are related. These 4 elements are related to B under some condition. So what is domain? 1, 2, 3, 4 only. Not 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this 5 is not related here. So don't be confused with this. So this is the domain. How you have to represent the domain of the relation is, x is an element of A, then x is related to R for some y is an element of B. X or y, comma, for some y is an element of B. X is an element of A such that x or y for some y is an element of B. So, please don't write all the elements given in the first set when they are asking domain. What are the elements you have taken to relate with B, then those elements alone, it is the domain. Do you follow? Thank you, Dama. The core domain of the relation is B. So, the second set is always the codomain. It is not like domain. The second set is the codomain always. Then, the range of the relation, why we are saying codomain is the second set is because when the image is formed, when the elements in the second set is formed as the images, then it is called a range. Then it is called range. Suppose, here if you have Mary, extra name. But what Madhi, Arul, John, Mary, that is codomain. But what is range here when they are asking range? Madhi, Arul, John, that is range. So codomain is the complete second set. The second set is called codomain, but range, the images are there. So range is the subset of codomain. Range is the subset of codomain. Codomain is nothing but the second set. Codomain is nothing but the second set. But domain is not the first set. Suppose if all the elements are related, then first set is the domain. Do you follow? Here the 5 is left out. Here the 5 is left out. Suppose this 5 is also related with Mary, then what is domain? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Do you follow? So, for that only they have given like this. Domain of R is a subset of A. Sometimes it may be a proper subset, sometimes it may be an improper subset. Codomain is R equal to B. Codomain is R equal to B. Domain is R is the subset of A. That is improper subset or proper subset. What is meant by improper subset? The given set. The given set. Proper subset means other than the given set. Do you follow? Codomain is what? Nothing but the second set. R equal to B. The codomain of R equal to B. Then the range is what? Range is also the subset of B. Subset of the second set. It is also a improper subset or proper subset. Sometimes all the elements will become an image. Or some of the elements it may not be. Do you follow? Do you follow every one of you? Now you understood the relation? Yes. So when you represent this, relation here, Cartesian product. So, relation is the subset of the Cartesian product. The inner circle represents relation. The outer circle represents Cartesian product. Do you follow me?